So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new team review video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the best way to play with Manchester City. I played a match against someone, he rage quitted in the first half. I was already in front with 4-0, but I didn't save the gameplay. It's really shit, sorry for that. But you have to trust me on this. It's a really wonderful formation. Played a few matches, win them all with some lovely attacking football. So if you like to play attacking football, watch this video, copy my tactics and try it out. Let me know in the comments what you think about, if you like it or not. I really want to know if other people like it as well. So let me know. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any new videos I'm posting. And if you like this video, drop a like, it's really useful for me. I'm gonna show you the formation, the lineup, the tactics and the instructions. So starting with the formation, it's a 4-3-3 holding formation with the lineup. Ederson is the goalkeeper, 91 rated, really good goalkeeper of course. Walker is the right defender, Stones and Laporte are the center backs, Cancelo is the left defender. Fernandinho is the central defensive midfielder, De Bruyne and Bernardo Silva are the central midfielders. Then we're going to the right side to Sterling. Sterling is the right winger, Sané is the left winger. I already showed you guys this in other videos and always getting the comments, why don't you switch them? If you like to switch them, you're really welcome to do that. It's not a big thing. But I like to play with wingers, a left-footed winger on the left side, a right-footed winger on the right side, because they cross the ball better, in my opinion, when they are at the right side with their good foot. So that's why I choose Sterling on the right, Sané on the left. But if you like to do otherwise, you're really welcome. It doesn't matter for the tactics at all. Aguero is the striker, of course, best striker, one of the best strikers in the game. Then we're going to the defensive style, the tactics. It's drop back with a width of 5 bars and a depth of 6 bars. Offensive style is balanced with a width of 8 bars, plays in the box 5 bars, corners, free kicks, both 3 bars. Going to the instructions then, Walker stay back while attacking, Stones and Laporte are just default, Cancelo at the left side stay back while attacking. Then we're going to Fernandinho, cut passing lanes, stay back while attacking and cover center. Then we're going to De Bruyne, get forward and cover center, that's the only thing I changed for him. Bernardo Silva, get forward, stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center. So what this is, Fernandinho is staying back, De Bruyne and Bernardo Silva are getting forward. So there can be a bit of a gap between your midfielders. For me personal, it wasn't a big deal because you have so many options when you are attacking. When you pass secure and be a bit patient at the time, try not to lose the ball. It doesn't matter at all, that gap between your midfielders. If you are someone who is losing the ball by a false pass or something and you think this is a problem for me, put the Bruyne not on get forward but on balanced, so the gap between your midfielders is a bit smaller and maybe that's a better option for you. But for me, both getting forward, really wonderful. You have so many options at attacking. De Bruyne gets into the box, Silva on the edge of the box. So for me it was really wonderful working this. Then we're going to Sterling, stay wide, get in behind, get into the box for the cross. Same for Sané, stay wide, get in behind, get into the box for the cross. Why? The stay wide is really good when you have the ball at your defenders. So Sterling and Sané are at the side of the field, and with Silva and De Bruyne getting forward, you don't want them to cut inside or something because there are too many players in the center of the field. But with the get into the box for the cross, when you are close to the box from your opponent, they will come inside, so they will be an extra option for you to play the ball to and create some chances and scoring some goals. So that's why I'm choosing these instructions. Aguero is only getting behind a lot of things are just default. So let's see the substitutes. We have Mahrez, really wonderful player, of course. Good to replace Sané or Sterling. Jesus, really wonderful player as well. Can play on the wings, can play as a striker. So you can use him for both. Silva is really useful when you want to replace one of your midfielders, Silva or De Bruyne, when you want to attack more. Then we have Rodri. Is really useful to replace Silva or De Bruyne when you want to defend more, or Fernandinho when he is tired. You can replace Rodri for Fernandinho. Then left defender Mendy, good left defender of course. Otamendi as a center back, and Bravo is the goalkeeper. So that's it for the Manchester City video. I hope you liked it. If you did, don't forget to like the video. It's really useful for me if you will do that. If you have to say something, want to ask me something, drop it in the comment section below. If you are new to my channel and didn't subscribe yet, make sure you will do that so you don't miss any new videos I'm posting. For now, this is the end. Have a great day. Bye bye.